No, I guess I better get started. Oh! Kill the rocks before they come alive and attack you from behind. No, they don't do that actually. Yeah, well, I don't know about quality. Maybe low quality, but you didn't specify high quality, so... so it's fine. Oh, look. Oh, yeah. Also, since last stream, I did massive amounts of level farming. Grinding. Level 108! That's even higher than I was at the end of my first time playing through the game, so hopefully... that'll take the edge off this as well. And make the whole game piss easy, mate. Yeah, that's more like it. Especially in this game. I can't remember much about this place other than a certain poisony area. It basically has the Blight Town of this game in a way. At the bottom of it. Kind of. Oh, one hit. Oh god. Overleveled much? There's Blight Town. Oh yes. I'll have to make a game that has a swamp, and the creatures you meet down there are dragons. And you don't actually learn what the swamp water is unless you pick up some items and read the descriptions to find out that it's like dragon toiletings that never go dry because of some magic, so it's forever fresh. And forever stench. That would be gross, actually. I don't want to make that. Just like the Labyrinth movie, The Bog of Eternal Stench. Yep, you know me. The only thing it could be. It's hard to tell what anything is around here. It's all grey and blocky. It really is Minecraft. Wait, what is that? Got a light coming out of it. That's weird. Welcome back, Muff Gib. I saw some of the stuff about your Glasgow thingy. About how you discovered double-deckers. It's been forever since I've had that. Oh no, this is an NPC. Oh no. And there's a crystal lizard that just buggered off because of you. First time I played, I thought this was another player. And I thought this was the only place that had... player. Ah, PvP stuff. For some reason. But no, I guess not. Oh. Oh god, I've cheaped everything. I can just tank it all because I overleveled. It's nice when you're able to do that. Yeah. But no, you shouldn't be able to get invaded when you don't have PS Plus. I don't remember exactly what double deckers are like because it's been forever, but I'm pretty darn sure they were tasty AF. I kind of want to reload the area. Oh, the area now.
Reload the area!
Because that dude got away. Oh! Die in one hit, pretty much. They were alright. Oh, they were alright. Not saying they were alright. Oh no. Okay, I thought he was disappearing. Oh no. It was a trap. I'm not going in there yet. Bare bones online. I don't remember actually. I don't remember if you get messages in the online mode without PS Plus. I should have turned it on. What is going on over? Oh. Poison. Oh no. Oh, don't look. You're not gonna sleep well tonight. It's like Gaping Dragon, Squid Edition. Oh, and they do rapid poison. Oops. Only 9 or 10 in a whole week? That's not good enough. I didn't see that story. You know, all this over-leveledness is kind of making me realize something. Something very strange that I never thought I'd be saying. I kind of miss the difficulty now. Being able to tank everything and just completely destroy all the enemies. I guess the difficulty really is part of the awesomeness of these games. Like, it makes you feel accomplished. Which is very weird, because I usually like a relatively easy experience, because I'm just here for fun. Never mind, half the health gone. Yeah. It'll be interesting to see how the boss of this area goes. It's a pretty dodgy one. That was probably a waste, it was almost over. Oh, what? Oh. Yeah, that's a bit lame. An entry fee every time you enter, not just one time. But yeah, I don't know. There's quite a few ways you get more power in this game. Oh. Like, the level up certainly did help, because pretty much every level was starting to give me 3 or 4 points in my weapons, at least every point I put into strength or dexterity. So from all the grinding, it was probably like an extra, I don't know, 30 times 3 or 4 points, whatever that is. But there's also, yeah, the weapon upgrades and the blood gems that you can put on the weapons, which give like plus 14% extra attack or something. So it all adds up. Wow, there's those rocks that do all the damage in the world that normally you'd want to pay more attention to so you don't get hit by them. But they can pretty much one-shot you normally. I guess it maybe kind of looks shamblery, in a way. Like a skinny shambler. Must just be an over-strict twat of a bouncer. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if there was some kind of Shambler-inspired enemy in this. Since there's a lot of Lovecraftian themes and stuff. Especially in the DLC, or not DLC in this version, since it's just included anyway. Yeah. I assume it's still Miyazaki in charge of the creature designs. Maybe they have another area of the studio or whatever that's more in charge of that. Oh no, come back. I don't need you because I've got max leveled weapons anyway. But it's stuff. Oh yeah. No, there's also dragons. And slightly smaller dudes in armor. Oh, and there's dudes in armor that have a hammer instead of a sword. And let's not forget the very creative giant rat. Or was it a wolf? No, don't clothe the dragons. I would hate the game. It's a big puffy thing with puffy friends. Om nyom nyom. Moldy. I'm trying to get a proper look at the moldy creatures with moldy faces all over them. Ooh. Somehow I hit that one as well. Hopefully the... Oh, what was that? Oh no! Oh, they've seen me already. Hopefully that experience in the bar was the only bad part of the trip. Oh, I have to stand in poison. While this is going on, I'm just gonna have to do it. This is the place to use all the stuff. At least they die quickly. Messenger's gift. What is that? Oh. Changes user into a messenger? I guess that must be like the... What do they call it? Chameleon of this game. I might have to experiment with the magic at some point. It just feels like it'll be a bit awkward because you kind of don't start getting it until a bit later in the game. Oh, yes, please. Stealth coming. Chameleons can get away with it and no one will ever see them. There could be a chameleon on your bedroom wall right now. And that is why you sometimes wake up with drool on your pillow, because it's not actually drool. Don't run off the edge, if there is an edge. Oh. Some rock man is angry again. Oh! Hi. Oh yeah. Yeah, sorry, this game is rated PEGI everyone. I don't know what the PEGI rating for everyone is. PEGI 0. I don't know where I'm going and where I've been. I think I've been over there because I remember seeing that lantern. Bloody poison stealing all my blood vials. Oh. Is that? No, that's somewhere I've been, I do believe. Let's have a look anyway. No, it isn't. It's this place. The place with all the rock men. Oh. Oh, so that means in PEGI land, anyone who's younger than 3 years old can never play video games. This makes no sense. No wonder it's called Nightmare Frontier. I want that. Cold blood flower bud. Say that as many times as possible. Cold blood flower bud, cold blood flower bud, cold blood flower blood. Yeah. Teach them that you have to work hard for anything in life. A very true lesson. Oh. I got too cocky, not paying attention to the rocks because I thought they wouldn't do enough damage. Yeah, cocky! Great, where was that now? Yeah! Oh. How did I miss that before? I guess because it was up here. That's alright. I want to get over there. Do those dudes come back? I don't know, because I don't know where I am. Okay. Never mind, it's not too far away at all. As long as I don't get hit by any rocks on the way back to my stuff, which I don't really need. I've got more than I'll ever need from now on, probably. But you always want more stuff. It also teaches you that about life. The more stuff, the better. Get those hoarding instincts. And it teaches you that if anyone ever kills you and steals your stuff, you always want to get them back. Oh, there we go. I just dashed through the fire and the flames, and carried on. Oh. Watch out for holes. The ground is infinite. It just instantly regrows whenever they pick it up. When will technology be so good that if an enemy like that exists, it actually digs like a hole in the ground that is permanent, like Geomod. Actually, yeah, Geomod technology already exists. Where am I? Oh. All scary. It all looks the same. Luckily, this is pretty much the most annoyingly designed area in the game. And the rest of it isn't all looking the same. Whey! What a cool dude I am. Or girl. Ah. There we go. That's how I get over there. Oh, welcome back again. Shinies! This isn't gonna work though, is it? Look at this trail of coins. What could be over here? Stuff that doesn't matter, because I already killed a thing. I need to close the window because the bloody sun. As in the blind. I didn't think it was going to be a problem because this screen isn't angled anywhere near the window, so the sun wasn't going to ruin it, but nope. The light pervades all. He's just relaxing. Oh! What a cool dude. Clockwise metamorphosis. What the mold is that? Something I've already got. I don't remember where you go. I guess over there somewhere. Where am I? Oh. Across the lake of shite. Due to the over-leveledness, I'm also not paying attention to stamina. It's ruining everything. Yeah, I guess so. Isn't that beautiful? It's got a bunch of skeletons in it or something. What a majestic display that was. Wouldn't you be turned on by this creature? What the? Yeah. Yeah, it depends on the kind of game. Like, it works in this game because it's supposed to have a feeling of hopelessness and dead worldness or something. But then you could argue that Doom is supposed to have a feeling of hopelessness because you're overwhelmed by demons. Oh, I wish I was. But no. I think you pretty much mean all of Doom 64, don't you? And all of PSX Doom. But I don't know. There's probably a specific one you're thinking of. I don't know which one it would be. I think I've already been here, haven't I? Yes. Laggy shadows. I'm sick of wading through centuries old whatever this is. Yum. Probably eternity old, knowing this game. Because eternity is a concept that can't be comprehended. Ah. The flora just jiggled. I'll have to replay Doom 64 someday, because the only playthrough of it is an old live-streamed one and the quality is terrible. It belongs on the main channel as a good quality thing. Oh, she immediately knows, probably because her whole head is surrounded with eyes and braininess. What arsehole thought up the frenzy mechanic? Good, I survived. My head did not explode. Chunky nut bars. Yeah, pretty much. I'm gonna have to try and hold still so you can listen to them for a bit. They're the worst enemy in the game. Doom 64 EX, I'm not sure what that is, but hopefully it's easy to set up. Is there? Oh, I thought there might have been another one down here. Oh, it's down there actually, I think. I don't want to go down there though. I don't want to go down there though. Maybe round here? Nope. I don't understand why you get so many lead elixirs in this place. Oh. I was just trying to check out the sky, but then some grass got in my eyes.